It's great. I mean, it's really exciting. So, I don't know. I mean, I've never been to the Children's Athens before. I've never been to the BAFTAs before. So it's been a year of firsts and very exciting events like tonight. So I just hope some other people in our category are here, because there's some amazing films that are up against. And Pixar nominated. So if Pete Doctor's here, I think I'm going to faint and then kind of, you know, start sort of gently foaming at the mouth with enthusiasm, because I'm such a fan. I think it's hopefully something that tells you something about the world and how we live our lives in it, and makes you leave the cinema feeling that the world can be a pretty great place. Like, that's what it does to me, because it feels it's a time for... There are films that can bring tremendous optimism and engage with big, sad issues as well. And all of my favourite children's films, from sort of, you know, E.T. through the Pixar movies and, you know, way back, kind of deal with big, interesting issues. And I think the point about children's films is, especially these days, they're just films. I mean, I watch so many of these films for pleasure on my own. I don't have kids, and it's just a joy. It feels like we're in a real golden age of children's entertainment.
Of course, Paddington is one of our most enduringly beloved characters. Why do you think he is a character that seems to transfer from generation to generation?
I think he's been well loved by Michael Bond, who's created an extraordinary character and world for him to inhabit. And I think people who've taken on the kind of responsibility of making Paddington at different times have taken it hugely seriously. I know I did. So the main thing was just trying not to mess it up and trying to take care of this bear. The clues in the label is, please look after this bear, and I think people want to. And certainly everyone on our crew worked their absolute hardest to do right by the character. Yes, we're making another one, so fingers crossed, at least assuming I can get the script right. So I'm trying to write it at the moment. And the books are an amazing source. There are so many great sequences and great set pieces. We're spoiled for choice. The challenge is to find a story that feels as kind of essential and dramatic as the first one without kind of breaking the world that he lives in. So we're trying, and fingers crossed we'll do okay.
Is the writing process slightly easier now that you have Ben's voice to kind of breathe life into the character for a new generation?
Yeah, I think it's definitely easier now we've got all of the characters, to be honest, and we got a sense of who the Browns are and that I was really discovering last time. But there are challenges as well, because the sort of big, broad arc of leaving Peru and coming to London, we've sort of done. So there's some story work to do as well.